Next, I'm going to take a few minutes to define what a secant line is and what a tangent line is. And then in the next video, we'll look at the relationship between secant lines and tangent lines. Now, if you were paying close attention in the previous videos, all of this that I'm about to talk about should seem pretty familiar to you. It's a lot like the relationship between average velocity and instantaneous velocity. So let me start by just writing a definition of a secant line. Okay, so a secant line is just a line joining two points on a curve. It's pretty simple, really. So a line joining two points on a curve is a secant line. So to relate this back to the videos you just watched, the average velocity is the slope of a secant line from a position versus time graph. So in those previous videos, when Jim was calculating the average velocity, what he was really doing was calculating the slope of the secant line from the position versus time graph. But let me show you what a secant line looks like on a graph. So here's a graph of a simple parabola, y equals 1/2 x squared. So like I said, a secant line is just a line joining two points on the curve. So let's start by drawing a secant line. Okay, so I'm going to actually draw several secant lines, so I'm going to use different colors to make them a little easier to see. Okay, so the first secant line I'm going to draw is going to go between x equals 1 here and x equals 3. Now, of course, the line will continue on in either direction here, but those are kind of the reference points I'm using. Okay, so let's take a look at the secant line here, and let's find its slope. Okay, so I'm going to create a chart out here to the side. I'm going to actually end up drawing several secant lines, and we're going to calculate the slope of those different secant lines. Okay, so this first one I'm doing is the interval I'm looking at is between 1 and 4. Sorry, I said 3 before, but it's actually between x equals 1 and x equals 4 that I'm looking at with this line. Okay, so how do I find the slope of a secant line? Well, I just find that slope like I would find the slope of any other line. Change in y over change in x. Okay, so what that's going to be in this case is f of 4 minus f of 1. So the function value at 4 minus the function value at 1 over 4 minus 1. So that's just change in y over change in x. Now f of 4, if I look at my equation there, that's going to be 1/2 times 16, so that's 8. F of 1 is 1/2 times 1, so that's 1/2 or 0.5, and that's over 3. And so if you work that out, you should get 2.5. So this is a lot like the formula for average velocity, right? Because like I said, the average velocity is just the slope of a secant line. Okay, so that's the slope of our red secant line. Okay, so let's do a few more secant lines. Let me draw one between x equals 1 and x equals 3. And I'll make it a blue line this time. So let's do a nice blue line. All right, and I want to go between x equals 1 and x equals 3. Okay, and let's calculate this slope. Okay, so now I'm looking between 1 and 3. So once again, the slope of the secant line is just the normal slope formula. So that's going to be f of 3 minus f of 1 over 3 minus 1. F of 3 is 1 half times 3 squared, so that's 1 half times 9, or 4.5. F of 1 we've already calculated, right? That's 0.5. And this is over 2, so that's 4 over 2, or 2. Okay, so the slope of the blue secant line is 2. All right, let's do just one more secant line. We'll do green this time. And this time I'm going to go between 1 and 2. So hopefully you can see that green line there. Okay, and once again, let's go ahead and calculate this slope as well. So now I'm looking at the secant line between 1 and 2. So I'm going to do f of 2 minus f of 1 over 2 minus 1. Okay, f of 2 is going to give me 1 half times 4, so that's 2, minus f of 1, which we found to be 0.5, 2 minus 1 in the denominator is 1, so that's 1.5. Okay, so what do we see when we look at these slopes? So I've got the slopes of three different secant lines, and I can see that actually these slopes are decreasing, right? I've got 2.5, 2, and then 1.5. And if I look at the graph, that makes sense, right? Because the secant lines are getting a little flatter, right? They're getting less steep as I go down. And we'll go into a little more detail about that actually in a few minutes. But now, let me switch gears and tell you what a tangent line is. So the easiest way for me to tell you what a tangent line is just going to be to draw it on this graph. So let me go ahead and do that. And to make it clear, let me use a different color. So let's see, maybe I'll use this purple color here. And let me make it a dotted line. And a little thicker. Okay. So, let me draw this in, and then I'll explain what's going on. Okay, so hopefully you can see that line there. Okay, and let me just write a little note here for you. So, this is the tangent line at x equals 1. Okay, so remember, a secant line connects two points on a curve. Now, what a tangent line does is it just skims one point on the curve. Okay, so my tangent line just touches at x equals 1, but that's the only point it touches on the curve. Okay, so that's what a tangent line is. And in just a second, we're going to go into detail about the relationship between secant lines and tangent lines.